morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.
Greetings out there in the world.
However, whenever you're watching this, we appreciate you because you already know time is expensive.
Yes, thank you for tuning in.
And thank you for subscribing. But if you have not, and if you really don't, you don't know, but this show is about anything and everything
creative.
Anything that sparks your creativity, whatever medium you dabble in.
Yes, expressing the soul, speaking your heart.
And welcome to another episode of Creativity
Unsheathed.
I'm Olaf Siegel.
And I'm the brother Nino.
And yes, we're brothers.
Yes, we are.
Says right there.
Yes, sir.
And this is the show where we feel.
This is the show where we feel that learn to clean up after yourselves.
Like that old saying, our parents taught us better.
Yeah.
It's just one of those things. It's like,
yeah. You know, some use it probably as a defense mechanism.
Possibly.
Right? Keep away and just wants to be alone.
True. That's possible.
So
that's possible. Hey. They're just doing it on purpose. Just
yeah.
Alone, right. Why we're talking about this and what we're looking in today is damage control.
Nice.
It's a 3-part run and it's coming out of the World War Hulk after Smash and damage control coming in to clean up after him and created by one of my favorite writers, Dwayne McDuffie.
Nice, hell yeah.
Yeah, but it's not Ernie Colon who he originally created Damage Control. But overall, it's just pretty cool to see that Dwayne McDuffie gets to touch his own creation again. And just being a milestone icon and just being the phenomenal writer that he is. And, you know, it's pretty cool that he was able to still come back at Marvel around this time and still do some work.
For sure, man. Mm-hmm. I would hate to be the one to clean up after the Hulk, man.
No, seriously, especially after an event like World War Hulk.
Well, you rarely see a JRJR animal.
Like, maybe he had, like, this is his comment about the Hulk, that whole variant
code
scheme, you know?
The bing, so it's like, hey. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a good one.
And here is John Romita Sr. with doing the cover. That's pretty cool. It's a nice treat.
Yeah, that's cool. Wow. Get both.
Mm-hmm. All right, so let's drop into this one.
Father and Son.
See how it looks.
Whoa. So pretty much a cleanup crew, huh?
Yeah, that's what they pretty much are. And
it's a cool helicarrier. Run the shield helicarrier.
We're in the middle of Shield's conversation of how to clean up this whole catastrophe that just had that happened with World War Hulk and trying to get a contractor to get it done. And
you got Tony Stark here, Antonio Starks. JRJR art. Would make Duffy on the scribe, right? And it'll look like Milestone. Amateur World War. Kind of like San Francisco. Definitely digital.
Cool, but I don't know, just something about it is like really boring to me. Mm-hmm. Like, it's not the story, it's like, you know, it's pretty standard, like, you know, like,
I feel like updated Archie almost,
yeah, Archie, you know, but it's just like, you know, it was, of course, you have all these like C-list actors,
yeah,
or C-list characters, but I don't know, it's just really boring, and it's like, even though it's digital. And then you have able to do cool effects like this. Mm-hmm. It's something about digital art. It just looks boring, no life into it. Mm. Mm. Okay. It's nothing really cool to look at. It's like it's not even about the story.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. Works just two dots compared to that.
The nephew of the original Black Goliath that got killed during Civil War. Oh. By the robotic Thor that killed him.
Mm.
Yeah, because he was supposed to be out of the picture during that story arc.
I don't know. Do you like Venom?
This version?
Yeah, with his eyes like that. Like, you see his pupils.
Yeah.
I guess if they wanted to break away from Tom McFarlane's version, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
But with the whole 90s look.
Like the next one.
Yeah. I think it's better. Might get better. Let's see.
What's a real treat, guys?
Let's see. 2 out of 3. Two out of 3. That's a pretty cool mashup of all the different
events.
Logos.
That's pretty cool.
Whoa.
Pretty much got all of them.
Wow, that's pretty cool, though.
Matt Gargan, huh?
Mm-hmm.
The original Scorpion. The damage so far. Betrayed by his former friend, the Hulk, was rocketed to another planet. Far from the stars.
Damage Control, created by Dwayne McDuffie and Ernie Cullen.
Hell yeah.
Cool. Creative team up front. Still the same one from issue 1.
Yeah.
Digital was okay. The art's good. You know, he knows how to draw.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I don't know. Just something about what it with the digital art compared to like the 80s and 90s art.
Yeah. Just
it really looks boring. Just after looking at that Steve Scorosi art.
Yeah, no, like, I agree.
Oh man, like, that really like
just make this look like it's classic.
Yeah, dude, like, I don't know. Alright.
Yeah, the actual totally different feel.
It's like there's no storytelling. This is like a bunch of just figure drawing.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah. It's like just cool pictures. That's it.
Yeah.
Slapstick. You rarely see this guy.
That's pretty cool. It's like a Looney Tune, Tex Avery type character in the Marvel Universe.
Hell yeah. That's finally a nice shot.
Speedball. Steve Ditko creation turned into penance.
And this is what started the Civil War.
Right. With the whole
combustible kid
explosion in the school. All because of a YouTube channel or their show that they try to do.
Yeah.
So you guys don't do things for views and likes. Be real.
It can hurt people. It can end up hurting innocent people.
Know your why.
Let us know what you think about this. First, I don't know. Slow burn. Penance? Cthulhu. Cthulhu. Human torch. Hmm. It kind of looks like Udon, huh?
Nah, Udon's better than this. Yeah, I'm talking about the soup. But as far as Udon Company, I think Udon artists, they can do better stuff than this, honestly. Yeah. But I feel like it's just figure drawing.
Yeah.
Just like, there's no real sequential, I think. It's like you have to really rely on to read the dialogue.
Like, there's no cool angles and stuff.
No. But I mean, it is worth getting just for the McDuffie writing and knowing that it's his creation.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, as far as the art, you know, it's okay. Just had looks really lifeless.
Yeah, it's like, even if you're just trying to follow it without the dialogue.
Right, it just looks boring. It's just, again, it's nice, pretty pictures.
Well, you don't really see much hatching, right?
No.
No pencil details, no nothing.
But it's like.
Yeah, where you work, huh?
Probably like the most exciting thing that ever happened in this book so far. Just the crash of the building coming to life.
Mm.
And
yes.
I mean, I think that's pretty cool that you get to see the meta and science of Dwayne McDuffie. All right, that was damage control.
Damaging.
Obviously.
Nothing against the writing.
Because it's Dwayne McDuffie. But it's just the visuals. You know, it's just really boring, really.
No expression. Like,
you know, like, even though it's talking heads and, you know, talking scenes, you know, I figured I've just seen better.
Yeah, Will Eisner.
You know, like, it was like a lot of figure drawing and just nice pictures.
Yeah.
Nice drawings, but it's like, as far as a sequential flow, not really, no cool visuals. And again, the only thing cool thing was seeing that Chrysler building, you know.
It's probably almost equivalent to reading Frontline.
True.
That does the title when it came out during Civil War and all that.
Oh, yeah, true. As if like you're watching Law and Order or CSI.
60 Minutes.
Yeah, like if you're watching those type of shows, this is probably like right up your alley, because it just has all that lingo and talk of, you know, politics and numbers, figures, and assets and liabilities, you know, all of that talk.
Yeah.
So, you know, especially something coming out of an event like World War Hulk, you know, I think it's something what to expect. And with Dwayne McDuffie's writing, he's going to provide the right information, because, you know, he does his homework. Mm-hmm. You know, he does a lot of reading, and he doesn't just read comics. He picks up a lot of random stuff.
Yeah.
You know, according to Dennis Cowan, you know, he would go to the bookstore with Dwayne McDuffie, and he would come out with metaphysics, yeah, quantum physics, and it's like, wow.
Damn, it's pretty dense, like, stuff.
Yeah, so he just really, you know, you can just only imagine, like, what else is just going through his mind as he writes.
Yeah. And
what made him think of the Chrysler Building coming to life. So, mm-hmm, you know, yeah, it's just stuff like that. And, you know, that's pretty cool to appreciate. And it's probably worth getting if you want to know what happens in the, you know, final issue. Because, you know, we don't want to spoil anything for you guys. Knowing that we did show the second one, and that's unlikely of us, it seemed unfair because issue one was... there's really nothing.
Yeah.
You know? So yeah, we just wanted to show you that bit and show you guys that Dwayne McDuffie touched his creation again back at Marvel, you know, Damage Control. You know, but it would have been cool to see Ernie Colin on it and see what he would have done around this time.
Yeah.
No.
Cover.
Yeah. But you know, if you guys are fans of Dwayne McDuffie and you didn't know that he touched Damage Control, or that he even created Damage Control, now you know. And now you know he did an updated version of during the World War Hulk era. So, by all means, you can get it in the World War Hulk trade, or Omnibus, or maybe just Damage Control trade. I don't know, I'm not sure, but how Marvel or Penguin House goes about it. But, you know, pick yourself up a copy and support your local bookstore, comic book store, whatever bin you find it in. However you get your books.
Yeah, Damage Control.
Yeah, y'all. We're going to end this episode with a motivational quote for y'all. And let the value hit you for what it's worth. And if you heard it before, by all means, it's just another self-reflection of where we are today.
Yes, sir.
And this one is by F. Scott Fitzgerald, a writer.
Mm-hmm.
And it states, "Viality shows in not only the ability to persist, but the ability to start over." End quote.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely goes hand in hand with Damage Control. Just with another event like World War Hulk, and before this, Civil War, and, you know, even the real world, you know, what's going on today, you know, with Gaza and everything in Palestine, and, you know, war is real.
It's crazy.
You know, there is a lot of, you know, innocent lives that, you know, that get caught in the crossfire. But, I mean, I don't know. I don't have a lot to say.
When it's falling apart, when you think it's falling apart, it's falling on together.
Yeah.
It's like falling into place, you know. Like, it's like it's supposed to happen.
Right. That's true.
And like, let it, I guess.
Mm. Like, yeah, you got that shit off the skin.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shit off the bad in order to show what's good underneath.
Yeah.
Makes sense. Yeah, I mean, it's just, I don't know, it just sucks how things have to go about, but, you know, there's no beauty without the ugly, and, you know, it's just vice versa, and that's the whole yin-yang of life, and just what it is, and, hey, it is what it is, y'all.
It's all part of the natural order, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, so it's like, it's the Damage Control, but let all of this be your self-reflection, and where you are today, and just... what you can do as a human being, and, you know, your ability to start over when you need to,
yeah.
And, you know, it's okay to start over.
Yeah, lend a hand. Yeah.
Yeah, and then, you know, it's okay to fail, and there's no real growth if you don't do that.
Yeah.
You know, every chapter has to end sometime, and, you know, for World War Hulk, it did. You know, it was a chapter of the Marvel Universe, and then now, I don't know. I don't know where we are in comics, or I don't know where we are in the Marvel events now.
Yeah.
But I think it's just too much, too many events.
I agree.
From what I'm seeing, and it's really hard where everything is. It just seems like everything's out of continuity, you know, to be honest. So
we're just throwing whatever, you know, on the wall and see what sticks.
Yeah, and I feel like where we say, you know, stay creative, keep creating.
Yeah. Stay independent, have your own voice.
You know, do your best to be a human being. Stay motivated and keep going.
Yeah, man. Spread the love and kill the negativity, guys.
Yes, sir.
Times is crazy right now.
Too crazy.
Too crazy, man.
So, till next time, y'all.
Till next time.
Peace.
Peace. We can't control everything, but a little goes a long way.